Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Chell, and now finally we're going to get to Cannabis's question. Cannabis sent this question in last week, and when I saw it, I had a laugh because it instantly reminded me of that conversation with Eric about totaling numbers diagonally, and then subsequently Chip Pearson teaching me how to total numbers diagonally. Yesterday, we took a look at how to total numbers diagonally, and Cannabis's question is a little bit more difficult. He says, hey, I have this data set, and right here, I need to add up the number immediately adjacent, but then as I go over additional columns, I need to go back additional rows. So basically, he wanted to total up all of those blue cells here in column A. Now, yesterday, we used a formula from Chip. It was an array formula that said, hey, we're going to go through and compare the row number for each cell in this data set with the column number for each cell in this data set. And when they're equal, we're going to get a 1 and multiply that by the whole data set, basically just to give us the numbers along the diagonal. Well, this is a little bit more difficult because we kind of need to go backwards. And the first thing I do when I think about this is I say, okay, let's take this 5-row by 5-column area. And if we ask for the column number of all of those columns, I'm going to get column 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So I need a way for the row piece to return the numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 in this fashion. This should say 2. This should say 3, this should say 4. And so logically, what I'm thinking about is basically I want to take the active cell plus 2 rows. So here I'm working in row 16, but I want to go down to row 18 and say take the row number, 18, minus the row number that we find in this range. And so as I built this formula, I had to adjust Chip's formula a little bit. Basically said, hey, we're going to take the column of that whole range, B12 to F16, and see if it's equal to the row number that is 2 rows below us, in this case that's 18, minus the row number of each cell in the 5-row area. If all of that is true, then multiply it by B12 to F16, and sure enough that works. And because we've used no dollar signs throughout, as we copy that formula, it very easily goes through and gives us the totals of the last 5 rows in a diagonal. I have no idea why Cannabis has to do this. As soon as I saw the question, though, it reminded me of the web page from Chip. I had to go back to the website and figure out that formula. It's one of these things that I've dealt with twice now in 10 years. So I always had to kind of piece it through. That's why we did 2 netcasts about it. Thanks to Cannabis for sending in this question, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.